So yesterday we saw how to calculate the Laplace transform using the method of partial differentiation and partial fractions and perfect square method. So now let us see some more examples for this partial fractions. So the question that I left yesterday was, you have to calculate the Laplace transform of 1 divided by s square plus 1 divided by s minus 2. So what would be the Laplace transform? So firstly, what we will do, we will convert this into the partial fractions. Now you see you have this quadratic term and this one linear term. So this factor 1 divided by s square plus 1 s minus 2, this would be written as as plus b divided by s square plus 1 and then plus c divided by s minus 2. So when you solve this one, you would have 1 is equal to as plus b multiplied by s minus 2, and then we have c into s square plus 1. So now in order to compute these three constants, first is this a, second is b, third is c, we have to put the value of s. So firstly, we will put s is equal to 2. If s is equal to 2, left hand side is 1. Right, on the right hand side, we have this to be c s square plus s square is 2. So we have here 4, 4 plus 1. So that means the value of c is equal to 1 by 5. And then we will substitute we can substitute any number, so we can substitute s is equal to 0. So see, what do we have? We have 1 is equal to a into 0 plus b into minus 2, and then we have c. Okay, so what is the value of we can substitute the value of c here. So we have minus 2b plus 1 by 5, so we can calculate what is b. So you have 2b is equal to 1 by 5 plus or minus 1, yes, minus 1. So this would be minus 4 upon 5 is equal to 2b, or in other words, b would be equal to minus 2 upon 5. And similarly, we can also have the value of c. So how do we obtain the value of c? Sorry, we have the value of c, we have the value of a. How do we obtain the value of a from here? So you can simplify this. So you would have 1 is equal to, you can multiply this term with this term, so it would be a s square minus 2a, and then we have plus bs minus 2b plus c into s square plus c. So now we can compare the coefficients. So that means 1 is equal to the terms with a s squared, so that are a plus c, and then the terms with coefficients with s as a linear factor, so they are b, only b, and then the linear terms, they are minus 2a minus 2b plus c. So we can compare the coefficients. So on the left hand side, we only have constant term, and here the constant term is this one. So we have minus 2a minus 2b plus c is equal to 1. The coefficient of s here is b, so b, and here the coefficient of s is 0. So that means b is equal to 0 from here, which is not true. And so that means we made some kind of mistake. Yes, we also have this term 2as minus 2as. So this won't come here and this will come here. So the coefficient of s would be b minus 2a. Yes, instead of this one. So that means we would have these terms won't come. So we have with us फर्स्टली ए प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू जीरो बिकॉज हियर ऑल्सो द कोफिशियंट ऑफ एस स्क्वायर इज मिसिंग एंड वी हैव माइनस बी माइनस टू ए इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड वी हैव माइनस टू बी प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू जीरो. फ्रॉम हियर वी कैन इवेलुएट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए दैट इज माइनस सी एंड वॉट वॉज द वैल्यू ऑफ सी दैट वी गॉट वन बाई फाइव. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ ए इज माइनस वन बाय फाइव. सो द वैल्यू हियर इज माइनस वन बाय फाइव. So now we have all the values with us, therefore we can substitute it here. So our partial fraction 1 divided by s square plus 1 into s minus 2, this would be equal to a, the value of a is minus 1 by 5, s plus b, the value of b is minus 2 upon 5. So this is minus 2 upon 5 divided by this first factor s square plus 1, and then the value of c is equal to 1 by 5. So we have 1 by 5 divided by s minus 2. So this is the term. Now we can take the Laplace inverse for this term. So we take the Laplace inverse of this term and the Laplace inverse of this term. So see, what do we have finally? So finally, what would it become? So we can separate out the terms. So it would be minus 1 by 5 Laplace inverse of s divided by s square plus 1, and then minus 2 by 5 the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s square plus 1, and then plus 1 by 5 the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s minus 2. So this is what we have. So now what is this quantity? Its Laplace transform is equal to cos of t. What is this quantity? Its Laplace inverse is equal to sine of t, and the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s minus 2, that is equal to e to the power 2t. Using this formula, the Laplace inverse of 1 upon s minus a, that is equal to e to the power a t. This is for this formula, and they are the direct sine and cosine formulas. Okay. So this is the answer to this question. So now let us move on to next question. So the question is, we are to find what is the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s cube plus 1. So what would be the Laplace inverse of this quantity? So it would be 1 divided by s plus 1 into s square minus s plus 1. How? Because I have applied this quantity, this formula onto this quantity, a cube plus b cube, that is equal to a plus b, and then we have a square minus ab plus b square. So using this formula, because I can write 1 to be 1 cube, so this becomes this thing. So now I can apply the partial fractions onto this function, 1 divided by s plus 1 into s square minus s plus 1. So this would be equal to, this is linear factor, this is quadratic factor, so it would be as plus b divided by s square minus s plus 1, and then we have plus c divided by s plus 1. So what we can simplify this term, so it would be as plus b multiplied by s plus 1, and we have c into s square minus s plus 1. So this is the quantity that we have. Now we can have, for different values, we can obtain the coefficients. So you have the coefficients as, you can compare the coefficients and calculate the values. The value of A comes out to be 1 by 3 after calculation. The value of B comes out to be 2 upon 3. And the value of C comes out to be minus 1 upon 3. Therefore, we would have the Laplace inverse of 1 upon s cube plus 1 is equal to the Laplace inverse of this quantity. A is minus 1 by 3 and B is 2 by 3 divided by this factor s square minus s plus 1, and then we have plus the value of C. The value of C is minus 1 by 3 divided by the other factor s plus 1. So after partial fraction we obtain this term. So here we can separate out the terms. So we have minus 1 by 3 the Laplace inverse of s divided by s square minus s plus 1, and then we have plus 2 by 3 outside the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s square minus s plus 1, and then minus 1 by 3 outside the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s plus 1. Now the Laplace inverse of this quantity is not readily obtained. So what we have to do, we have to complete the square here. Complete the square. So how do we complete the square? We just take the coefficient of this mixed term, so its coefficient is minus 1. We divide that by 2, then we square that quantity, it is equal to 1 by 4. So we add 1 by 4 to it and we subtract 1 by 4 to it. So this would be equal to minus 1 by 3, the Laplace inverse of s divided by s square minus s plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4 plus 1. And similarly, we do this with this term. So this thing would again be s square minus s plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4 plus 1. And then we have minus 1 by 3, the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s plus 1. So now we can complete this square. So it would be equal to minus 1 by 3, Laplace inverse of s divided by, what is this term? This is the Laplace in square of s minus 1 by 2. So we have 1 by 2 whole square and we have square root 2 upon 3 whole square. And similarly, we have for the other term, Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s minus 1 by 2 whole square plus square root 3 by 2 whole square. And for the last term, it is equal to minus 1 by 3, the Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s plus 1. So now we can use the direct formulas. For this, we should have minus 1 by 2 here and plus 1 by 2. So that means now we can use the shifting property here. So accordingly, it would be equal to e to the power 1 by 2 t and then the Laplace inverse of the quantity, it is equal to s plus 1 by 2 divided by s square plus square root 3 upon 2 whole square. And in this term also, 2 upon 3, I can write e to the power 1 by 2 t, and then I would be left with Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s square plus square root 3 upon 2 whole square. And then for the last term, what is the Laplace inverse of this quantity? It would be equivalent to e to the power minus t. So that is the Laplace transform of third term. So now, in order to calculate the Laplace inverse transform of this quantity, so we will separate out the terms. So here it would be the Laplace inverse of s divided by s square plus square root 3 upon 2 whole square, and we have plus 1 by 2 Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s square plus square root 3 upon 2 whole square. And then we have plus 2 divided by 3 e to the power 1 by 2 t. What is the Laplace transform of this term? It is equal to sine square root 3 divided by 2 t. And the last term would be as such. So it would be minus 1 upon 3 e to the power minus t. So finally, we have the answer as minus 1 upon 3 e to the power 1 by 2 t. The Laplace transform of this term, this is equal to cos of square root 3 by 2 t, and then plus 1 by 2 sine square root 3 upon 2 t, and then we have plus 2 upon 3 e to the power 1 by 2 t sine of square root 3 upon 2 t, and the last term is minus 1 upon 3 e to the power minus t. So this is the final answer. So now you could club up the terms and simplify this a little bit. So that is the answer. So these are few of the examples for which you could solve the Laplace inverse of this partial fractions using this concept of partial fractions. So next we will see the concept of convolution theorem and how we can use this convolution theorem to calculate the Laplace inverse.